Alkaba Junior Academy, you're most welcome to this lesson. Once again, this is Teacher Tom Sura, taking you through mathematics primary six. Before we start today's lesson, I want us to go through the work we did last time. I gave you two numbers, and one number was saying, write down the first four place values in the following bases. Write down the first four place values in the following bases. Part A, we add base 3. So we are looking for the first four place values in base 3. So 1, we have 1s. 2, we have 3s. Roman 3, we have 3 3 3s. The last one is what we call 3 3 3s. So those are the first four place values under base 3. Part B, my children, was base 4. They asked us to mention the first four place values in base 4. We say base 4, this is ordinary base. The first one is 1s. How do you get 1s? 4 to the power 0 is 1. 2, we talked about another one, which is 4s. How do you get 4s? 4 to the power 1. So another one is 4s. Then Roman 4 is 4 4 4s. So those were the answers we're expecting to have. That is base 4. The base 9, that was our Roman part C, base 9. We are looking for the place values under base 9. Base 9 is nonary base. Roman 1, we have 1s. 2, we have 9s. 3, we have 9 9s. Then Roman 4, we have 9 9 9s. So children, these are the first four place values under base 9. So that was our number 1. That was our number 1. Then number 2. Number 2 was to find the place value of each digit in the following numbers. The first number is 1, 1, 2. 1, 1, 0, base 2. Once again, 1, 1, 0, base 2. Here we shall use the place value arrows to answer, because they have told us to give the place value each digit. So here we have 1s. Here we have 2s. Here we have 2. Here we have 2 capital letter. Here must be capital letter. 2 2s. So those were the answers. This was part A. Then part B, the number was 1, 2, 1, base 3. Another name for base 3 is ternary base. So here the first one, that is 1s, followed by 3s. Followed by 3s. We are talking about the position. S must be there, my children. So we shall have 3 3s. So 3s. So that is, this was the answer to that question. We move to part C. Part C. We have 1, 1, 3, 2, base 5. That was the question given us. So we are going to use the place value arrows. Don't forget that. This is 1s, because a number 5 to the power 0 is 1s. S, don't forget S. So we have here 5s. 5z. 5z. Here we shall have 5 5s. So those were the answers for that question. Last question, my children, was part D. part D, which is 1, 4, 5, verse 7. Don't forget that another name for verse 7 is Septenary. So, the first one is ones. 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 Next one, we have sevens with S. Sevens. Then last one is seven, seven Z. So those were the answers, my beautiful children. So if you got all the work correct, thumbs up. Thumbs up. Thank you very much. That was our work we did previously. Thank you very much. Now, after you've got all answers correct, then we have to move to today's lesson. Okay. Today's lesson. And make sure that you've done corrections, because when we meet again, I have to see that book, then to mark with my red pen. So don't be lazy. I want you to do corrections where you have failed all of them. Okay. So I'm taking this one off because we are going to see what we're going to learn today in this lesson. Okay. Don't forget that yesterday we talked about place values of numbers in bases. Now today I'm going to talk about values of bases. Values of bases. Values of bases. Values of bases. We have started. Those who have not yet organized themselves, please try to follow. Values. Values. Values of bases. 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 When you understood how to find a place values of bases or of digits in bases, it is very simple now to find their values. Now, let us begin with question number one. Ask yourself what values are, or what is a value. Question one, or you can say not. A value is a product. A value is a product of a digit, and its place value. We are reading, children. A value is a product of a digit and its place value. Don't forget what we did in whole numbers. When I find digits, values of any digit in any given whole number. It's the same thing here. So to find the value of a digit, we shall get the digit itself and multiply it by that place value. Don't forget the word product means the result we get when we have multiplied. So that's called a product. In simple terms, our value is equal to the digit times its place value. So my children, that's the clear formula we use when I'm looking for the value of any digit in any numeral. So this is the formula we're going to use. So after knowing this, my good children, remember, there are some key statements talked about in the previous lesson. We talked about that any number to the power, any number to the power zero. Remember, any number to the power zero is ones. Don't forget that. For example, 2 to the power 0 is equal to 1. 5 to the power 0 is equal to 1. So this knot is very important. We are going to use this knot in today's lesson. So make sure that you remember this. Let's move on. Knot number 2. We say that any number to the power. Any number to the power 1 is the number. Any number to the power 1 is the number. It's solved. Any number to the power 1 is the number. It's solved. For example, my children, the power 1 is the number itself. So, with any number, the power 1 is the number itself. Therefore, 2 to the power 1 is 2. We have 5. 2 to the power 1 is 5. So this is also another note is very important because we are going to use it also in this lesson. So these things are very important. Let's read them all about. Let's go. Any number to the power 0 is 1. 2. Any number to the power 1 is the number it's solved. So those notes are very important. Now let's go to our examples. My children. Example one. Find the value of each digit. Find the value of each digit in the numbers below. So remember, I talked about this one in the other lesson that numbers mean numerals. So this is our question, our instruction. Find the value of each digit in the numbers below. The first number is 101 base 2. 101 base 2. That's the first example. There are two methods we can use. We can use powers of 2, or we can use place values of 2. So we can draw a table. And we set our number there. We can draw our table like this. This is our table. So we are using, first of all, place values. So write place values. So here we shall have down the number. That number given to us. We are dividing this number into 3 because we have 3 digits. The first one, 1. So we shall put your number there. 101. Is that okay? Now we are looking for the place values of 2s. So the first one is 1s. You can write them in the fearful form. Another is 2s. Then another is 2s. So have you seen that? So we are finding the value of each digit here. There are 3 digits in this number. So we shall begin with the first one. We say value of 1, which is equal to, we have said, we get the product of that digit at its place value. Now the value of 1 is 1 2 2s. 1 1 2 2s. Then you expand this, which is equal to 1 times 2 times 2, because we have 2 2s. What do we get here? Which is equal to 2 times 2, we get 4. So the value of 1 in this number is 4. We continue. Remember, answer our question the way it's supposed to be my children, they have told us to find the values of all the things forming this number. Don't stop there. So let's go to the value of zero. Value of zero, which is equal to value of zero, which is equal to, look at the place value of zero is twos. So we shall have zero twos. Zero twos. Continue expanding. Yeah, what do we get? Shall we get zero times two? And what is zero times two? Which is equal to zero. This is our answer. That is okay. Now we move to the last digit, and that digit is also one. So shall we get the value of one? Value of one. These ones are not the same. Why? Because they have different positions. They have different place values, so they cannot have the same value. So take note of the positions of these digits in the number. So here we shall have, look at that one. This one is, the place value is one, so we shall have one ones. One ones. Good. Then we move. We want to expand, which is one times one, which is equal to one. So my good boys and girls, we have found the values of these digits in this number. So that is method one. So those who have learned this one, it's okay. So I'm giving another method. We call it O. Here we have used place values, but we can use powers. Powers of that given base. So draw your table again. Draw your table again. Draw your table again. So these are powers. These are powers. Powers of that base, that given base, which is 2. Then we shall have our numeral. We shall have our numeral. Powers of 2. Powers of 2. Divide this table into 3 parts. Why have we 3 parts? Because we have 3 digits. Don't forget that. Okay. So the first, put your numeral there. 1, 0, 1. Are we together? Yes. Now, put the powers. The first power is 2 to the power 0. Because 2 to the power 0 is equal to 1s. Here we are using place values, here we are using powers. So we shall have here 2 to the power 1. Then it shall become 2 to the power 2. Altogether? Good. Now we continue. We have put us to find the value of 1. Value of 1. Value of 1, which is equal to. We shall get 1 times 2 to the power 2. These are 2 groups of 2. So we are expanding. This is the power telling us how many times to multiply this base. So which is equal to 1 times 2 times 2, which is equal to 4. Fine. We have got the same answer. Okay, let's move to this one. Value of 0. Which is equal to, we shall get 0 times 2 to the power 1. Don't forget that we talked about any number to the power 1 is that number itself. So what we get here? 0 times 2, and we shall get 0. So we are looking at the last. I told you these ones are not the same. Why? Because they are not in the same position. They are in different positions. So they cannot have the same value. So let's look at the last one, the last digit. Remember, you have got a definition of the value, and remember, I've got these notes you have talked about. They are very important in this lesson. Okay, value, the last one is value, the last one is value of one. The last one, that one is the place value of ones. So it's equal to 1 times 2 to the power 0. We talked about this, that any number to the power 0 is 1. So which is equal to 1 times 1. And the answer becomes 1. So we have answered that question, part A. I'm sure that you've seen the two approaches. So it is see you on to see which approach you go with. So that is example number one. I think you have got that. Let's look at the second example, part B. And bring this last one, then we shall have our activity. Because I think you got the skill of doing that. Okay. The next example is one, two, three, base five. We are going to see both approaches. The first one using place values, another using powers. Now, look here. This is base five. So we are going to use powers of five. Oh, we are going to use base values of five. So don't mix up the two. Here we have used place values of twos, of two, place values of two, because our base is two. Okay. We have said we draw our table. We draw our table. We are dividing it into three parts because we have three digits. The first approach, we are going to use place values. Down, we shall have our numeral. Don't get confused, numeral means number. The given number, the question. Now, we are dividing this table into three parts. I'm writing off here, sorry. We are dividing this table into three parts. So, that and that. Okay, here, put your digits there. Is that okay? We are dealing with power, place values of five. So we shall have ones. Here we shall have fives. Here we shall have five fives. Five fives. So after that, what do? We go value of one. Value of one, which is equal to, we shall have 1, 5, 5s. Now expand that. This is also going to be a question. Don't forget, they can ask you, work out 1, 5, 5s, which is equal to, we are going to expand, which is 1 times 5 times 5. We continue. What is 5 times 5? Which is equal to 25. So the value of 1 in this number is 25. We continue. Value of 2. Value of 2. Value of 2 is equal to 2 5s. Because the place value here is 5. You have 2 5. 2 times 5. 2 times 5. What's 2 times 5 is equal to 10. So this is the value of 2 in this number. Lastly, let's look at the value of 3. Okay. So I hope you've done this by taking it away. Okay. Look at the table. We have 3 ones. So we shall say value of three, align that, which is equal to 3 ones. Why is it 3 ones? Because the place value of 3 is ones. Now what do we do here? We expand. How do we expand? Which is equal to 3 times 1. We have written 1 in figures. This one is in ones, but I've said it in figures. We have 3 times 1. And what becomes our answer? 3. So the value of 3 in this number is 3. That is approach 1. Approach 2, we say we are going to use powers. Continue again. Don't forget, draw our table. In the first approach, we have used place values. In the second approach, we are going to use powers. But powers of what? Powers of 2, powers of 5. Don't forget that our base is 5. Okay, you divide your table. what we have here, these now are powers. Powers. And here we shall have our numeral. Yes. We are dividing this table into three. Why we have three digits? So we shall have one and then two, three. Down we are putting our numeral, which is one, two, three. What are powers? We are dividing powers of five. Here we shall have 5 to the power 0. 5 to the power 1. Then 5 to the power 2. Finished. Then from there we continue. Value of 1. Value of 1. Which is equal to? Okay. We shall have 1 times 5 to the power 2. Look here. 5 to the power 2. These are two groups of 5s. So we are multiplying 5 how many times? Twice. So we shall have here 1 times 5 times 5. Now simplify that. What do we get here? 25. We have got the same answer. When we use the place values, we have got the same answer, the same when we use powers. We move to the next one. Value of 2. Look here. This one is equal to, we shall get that digit and multiply it by 5 to the power 1. Remember our note, we say that any number to the power 1 is that number itself. So we shall get here 2 times 5. Now, what 2 times 5 is equal to? 10. Have you got the same answer? I think we got the same answer when we use place values. Lastly, we shall go to the value of 3. Value of 3 is equal to 3 times 5 to the power 0. 5 to the power 0. What do we say about this? We say that any number to the power 0 is 1. Therefore, this is equal to 3 times 1. And our answer is equal to 3. I got the same answer? Yes. Don't you see? These answers are the same. So, my children, those are the two approaches we can use. I know some books give other approaches, but Cambridge Junior Academy children, let's go by these two approaches. After this, now my activity. I think these examples are very enough for you to do my activity very well. When you're attempting my activity, don't use both approaches. Please pick one approach you have got so that you can do my activity very well. Last time I told you, please don't call anyone to help you. Please use your head, go through what you have discussed in the examples, and then you pass these numbers very well. So I have my activities on my chat. Going through the two examples, my children, this is our activity. I've told you don't use the two approaches. Use one approach you've got so that you can get these numbers correct. The first activity, the first number is find the value of each digit in the numbers below. Some people are lazy. They only find the value of 2 and they'll stop there. But here the question says each digit. So we want to see the value of these 3 digits. Then part B is 3, 2, base 4. That is number 1. Then number 2 is find the value of the unlined digits. Only these digits are unlined. Now this question is far different from the first one. Okay, the part A is 1, 2, 5, base 6. So in this case, you are looking for the value of 2. Part B is 3, 5, 7, base 9. So we are looking for the value of 3 in this number. That is part 2. Now part 3. This is number three. This is a bit of now reading. Find the product of the values of the unlined digits. Product, remember I talked about this word product, unlined digits in 2, 3, 1, verse 7. Now, this product, this is application question. Product means as you get after you multiply. So get the value of 2 and get the value of 7, a value of 1. Then you multiply, then you get the answer. So that those are the three numbers I would like you to attempt. Don't ask anybody. Please be sure of your answers. Thank you very much for listening. This has been our lesson today. May God bless you. We'll meet again in the next lesson.